Hi, in this video we're going to look at how you can use webhooks directly from your web application without the need to publish your application to a live server or cloud service. Webhooks play an important role in many web applications by handling user-defined HTTP callbacks. Webhooks can let your application know when a specific event occurs on a third-party service. More and more services are offering webhooks by allowing you to set a URL for HTTP requests. Software as a service providers such as Twilio, Dropbox, SendGrid, PayPal, and many others are now using webhooks. However, before using these in your web application, you usually need to either publish to a live server or to Azure so that your application can then be called from the internet. But what if you want to work with webhooks directly from your local machine? Perhaps you want to debug your application without having to publish it. Well, today I'm going to show you how you can use the Visual Studio extension called Conveyor, which provides incoming access to your web project through a tunnel, enabling your webhooks to be called on localhost. Conveyor is available on the Visual Studio extensions marketplace. You can download it directly from Visual Studio by going to the Tools and then Extensions menu, and in the Online section, search for Conveyor. Okay, so to get started, we're going to set up a simple webhooks MVC demo application in Visual Studio. In our case, we're going to set up the Twilio service to notify our application when a text message or SMS has been received and respond with our own specific message. This example project is designed to show you how Conveyor can be used to simplify the use of webhooks on your local machine. If you need more details about how to set up webhooks in the first place, please take a look at the numerous articles and projects online. Okay, let's create a new project. We'll be creating an empty ASP.NET MVC project. We won't be hosting in the cloud, so you don't need to select Azure. In order to use the Twilio helper libraries, we will need to install the Twilio NuGet package via the Package Manager console. Enter the following line into the console and hit return. Okay, to listen for the Twilio webhook, we'll create an MVC controller. Twilio will call our webhook once an SMS text message has been received. So right-click on the controllers folder in your project and select Add and then Controller and add an empty MVC5 controller. You can name your controller anything you like, it doesn't matter. Next, you will need to add the using statements to import the Twilio namespaces and change the controller class to inherit from the Twilio controller. Next, add the following code to the project. Of course, you can set up webhooks however you wish. But for our example, we have our response message set as Hello World, so when our webhook receives a notification of an SMS text message to our Twilio number, it will respond with our own message. So now we can go ahead and run our application. As this is a simple project with the only content being our controller, you will see an error message. That doesn't matter, we just need our project to be running in Visual Studio so we can make use of the webhook. Now the application is running, we can use Conveyor to obtain a publicly accessible URL that we can provide to Twilio. If you go ahead and click Access Over Internet button in Conveyor, it will provide us with the URL that we need. You may need to register for a Conveyor account if you haven't already done so. Calls to the Conveyor Cloud URL are tunneled to your localhost, so we can add the controller name to the Conveyor Cloud URL and then add that to the Twilio settings. That's it, we're ready to test it out now. I'll add a breakpoint so we can see what's happening a bit clearer. Now when I send an SMS text to my Twilio number, our breakpoint is hit. Clicking continue, you can see the message from our application is sent back to the mobile number. If we pause the application, we can alter the message. I'll send another text to my Twilio number without the breakpoint this time. You can see the new message is sent back to us. Oh, as we're using a free Twilio account, each of the messages from Twilio has the trial account prefix to it, so you can ignore that. And that's it. As Conveyor tunnels through your firewall and handles all the configuration settings, it makes it extremely easy to set up direct access to your web application. In the same way, Conveyor can actually be used to test your application from a variety of devices, either attached to your local network or over the internet. Well, I hope you found this video useful. If you have any questions or comments, please do let us know. Thank you.